world. Here's some news on this road. So anybody doesn't have the second one, the dark road right in front of heaven. Sherry, you have one? You all have it? There's two sets. One is okay, regular riding, one is like dark road riding from the window, I'm gonna say. Does you all have it? Recent? Okay. So today, we talk about subject that we talked about similar in the previous years, about Chola, someone is sick, Chola Sheish Masakona, someone is very sick, and he could even, Chas V'Shalom, he died. And what's the halacha about is eating on Yom Kippur? Of course, you know, it's a very serious, one of the most serious averos in the Torah, eating on Yom Kippur, Sukkot. And what should a person do on Yom Kippur? A lot of times, you know, this, to me, it's very nogeya, the shaila. I've been talking about different ways over the years, because 13 years ago, I think it was, that I had a surgery 3 days before Yom Kippur. It was a 9-hour surgery. My thyroid, I took out the thyroid, it was a surgery. The doctor, Dr. Friedman, so he said that he said he thinks I could eat on Yom Kippur. It was 3 days before Yom Kippur, and I, he said, and then there was a diagnosis of the time, but first he also, he agreed with them, they said I could eat. I remember Kol Nidre eating a peanut butter sandwich. It was kind of funny, but Kol Nidre is my house. My wife was home at Agava, and she was standing on top of me to make sure that I was going to eat something. Because the doctor and the very first, they said, you need something, you keep her right after the fast. It was just a 9-hour surgery, so I don't know, they said, you can eat something, I don't know, so I ate something. But a lot of people have the shailas about how much can eat on Yom Kippur. We have, first because of poison, if you have the shaila, you can ask, you know, the psak, which is the maisa. So we have, I know that, just saw Rabbi Zimmerman this morning, told me his wife had a baby boy, so he said that she's going to be able to eat on Yom Kippur. So within a couple of days of Yom Kippur, she can eat on Yom Kippur. And I have a granddaughter, I had a baby this last week before Shana. So she was very nervous about what she's going to do. She wanted to know what she can ask the question, what she should do. She said, is Rabbi first okay? I said, I think it's okay. You can ask him. So, you know, she has to think Rabbi Shabbos from Muncie. And she's going to do IV. So she's going to do IV. Some people do IV. You know, I think my brother does that. No, people, all right, Shiley, as the place you want to do that. I think Rabbi Yoshua also, they said, when he was very old, he also used IV. So that's a different answer. We'll talk maybe some other time about that. What is a good answer? Not a good answer. What do you use IV and not eating? But anyway, somebody don't have the second sheet. We have the second sheet over here. Okay, that's a different sheet. Okay, we have to talk about that another time. Not today's sheet. That's all right. It's over there. Hey, look. So maybe that's better. But I think not today's sheet. But anyway, there's a lot of different shilas. Anyway, that's not the second sheet again over here. But we're going to talk about something else today. We'll talk about Reb Chaim Risker. In his psak about eating on Yom Kippur, because we know that Chaim Risker was a guy, everybody knows, he's one of the great geniuses in the Torah world. And we study his Torah. Many people, you know, try to understand Chaim Risker and the Derech HaBrisk all over the world. They're trying to learn the Risker Derech, Chaim's famous Derech. But he really didn't pass in Shilas. He was the Roman Brisk, the fourth king before that. He was the Rosh Hashiva and the great Yeshiva of Lajan. And he didn't pask in Shilas Halachol Maisim. He said, give it over to the Dayan. The Dayan. He gave over to the Dayan, she passed the Shilas. He said everything. Anytime he asked for Shilas, he said, it was on Riga, I think. He said, it's a Mazel and Riga. He gave over to Shilas. He said, yes, the Rob. He didn't want to pask in Shilas. He said, yes, the Rob. And then the Romans have socks. So he might argue in the Lopez. But he said, okay, you paskin, it's okay. So he didn't want to paskin shaylas. But one shayla used to paskin was on Yom Kippur, Chola Sheish Masakona, somebody who's very sick, Chola Sheish Masakona, I'm talking about that a little today, that's our subject today. He would paskin on that person that they should eat regular. Shouldn't eat, the Shulchan Aruch says that a mubaris, a pregnant lady, or a chola, says the Shulchan Aruch, a chola or a mubaris, should eat pochus, maybe sheer. He less than shears, the Coseva Sagasso in a shear something, 2 minutes, 9 minutes, sometimes, you know, whether, you know, Mark Markel. So we have to somehow eat little bits. My doctors passed for me the last couple of years, they told me to eat Pops Bogan Gavetsa. They told me to go to Coseva. They told me to do that every 9 minutes, eat like another ounce. They told me to do that. This year, doctor, I asked him again. I said, I think I'm okay. And I fasted already Tishabov and it's on my diet. So I said, I think I'm okay. So the doctor, I did it without the doctors asking the first time. But then the doctor said to me, all you need is a blood thinner. Blood thinner is one thing. You take one pill, it's a blood thinner. And he says, take that one pill once, that's okay. And I guess that's stomach shock, there's a healer. I think take one pill, so you keep it. He told me to. So that's all I think is a sakana. He said, blood thinner, it's like warfare or something like that. So anyway, that's what he said to me. So I go with the doctor. If I don't listen to the doctor, I'm not doing the aloha, I guess. So, what? The bill's not there for chila. So the rabbi said, well, so doctor and the rabbi asking, I can take the one pill, and you keep it. That's what he told me this year. So I'm gonna, if I pass out, you know, you give me something. But otherwise, hopefully, Baruch Hashem will be good. And you keep it. A couple years ago, Shana didn't get asked. But anyway, but that wasn't for fasting. But anyway, that's what we're talking about today. So we're talking about now in the sheets. You look at the first sheet. We're talking about the it's a Gemara in Yuma. Chola machila loso api mikiyin. So you ask doctors who are experts usually in the field of what we're talking about, you know, because I know I have a lot of different doctors that are, you know, they're examining me, you know, you get different doctors. One doctor is an endocrinologist, so he says he doesn't really know that much about, you know, what's up on it. He says, you know, you get maybe diabetes, so he says that you can get some diabetes, maybe you can fast. He says, ask the heart doctor. So the heart doctor, he'll tell you if you can fast. So I asked our doctor, he said, you can fast, just take one pill. I said, okay, so that's, you got to go to experts. It says, machilo sopi abikien, the main shop abikien, machilo sopi atzma. So there's no baki, there's no doctor that say knows, you know, the impossible the shayla, let's say he doesn't, not, you don't have a cardiologist, or you have some guy that doesn't really know that much about, you know, the nutrition, which you eat. So the guy himself can pass the shayla. Pass it for yourself, the main shop abikien, machilo sopi atzma. Okay, now that's a Mishnah in Yuma. Now the Rambam, the same first page, the Rambam, in Shvisa Zosar, in the Be'el Hashem Kippur, Chol HaShesh Bo Sakana, Sheshoal Lecho B'Yom HaKippurim. So Chol HaShesh Bo Sakana, very sick person, Chol HaShesh Bo Sakana, could be whatever that could be, maybe a cancer, or some other things, Chol HaShesh Bo Sakana. So if he wants to eat on Yom Kippur, Abisha Rofim, Abakiyam, Omrim, Enot Zorich, so even the doctors will say, that's also in Bar Yuma. Doctors will say, you don't have to eat. Then Machino Sobi Atzma, he says, I want to eat, Atzma and die. It's enough. He says, I had enough. Then it's like, he can feed him as much as he says he wants to eat. He can feed him. Omra Choyda Enot Zorich, and the Choyda says, I don't have to eat. But Rofim Mer Zorich, no, you do have to eat. Machino Sobi. So you have to listen to the doctor. There's a mice I heard over from Rav Left that he had a person in Shul that he wanted to fast. The doctor says, you've got a heart condition, you've got to eat. And he says, no, I'm fasting. And well, he said, well, you could fast if you want to. He says, but I'm never giving you an aliyah in my Shul again. So he told him, he says, you can fast with me, but I can't give you aliyah. He says, well, why can't you give aliyah? He says, because if you don't listen to the doctor, you're quite for the Torah, because the Torah says you have to take care of yourself, and I'm never going to be able to leave my shul. So he told that. So that was what he was asking. So the guy, I guess, either he left the shul or he ate. I don't know what happened. But anyway, that was once when Rabbi Abramsky, the great Rabbi Abramsky, was in a shayla in his, he was a young rabbi, I think he was 25 years old, and he became the rabbi in a shul. There was a lot of chassidim in the shul, and he was not a chassid, he was a great guy, but he wasn't a chassid. And if one person surely told him, you gotta eat, told him on the Yom Kippur, you gotta eat. The guy says, you know, you're a young rabbi, I'm an old man, I'm doing what I want to do. Okay, Rabbi Abramsky says, okay, I pass, you gotta eat, you don't want to eat, you do what you want, but you better eat. And the guy had a stroke on Yom Kippur, he couldn't talk for 6 months. So the answer, Abramsky, how'd you know that? The guy, I think he's going to get sick, he says, well, he had a simbai. The Gemara says, if you look at that, he says, you gotta eat. I told him, it says like that, you gotta listen to me. So he didn't, he got money to eat, but he was sick for 6 months, he couldn't talk. And then he broke on Shabbat, he had a Fush Lema. But anyway, I'm not sure he had a Fush Lema, but there was, it says, the Shabbat, so anyway, the Rabbi says, Kol Shesh Vesakana, If he's cautious about cutting a keeper, Apishalofim, Bakim, Omer, and Elozar, you listen to his, a person can say on his own, he knows better. As the Gemara says, that Leif Yodea Moras Nafsha, who's a Pasuk Mishlei. Person can know himself as he's sick, and the doctor may think he's not so sick, but a guy himself can feel he's going to die or something. He can say better than the doctor. So we pass him with the, but if he says, I don't have to eat, the doctor says, I do have to, so we're cautious, the doctor is right, he's wrong. And then he's suffering the cautious, love Akhmar. So the Brisker Rav on this first piece over here, I have on the first page over there, but it's also in the Brisker Rav, you have that sheet with the, you know, the dark writing on it. That's from the Greece, Zev Soloveitchik, son of Reb Chaim. So here he brings this Rambam, and he says over there, you see on the right-hand column there, so he says, okay, the first page, I hope they get the Brisker Rav, but I don't have to put it on the right page here, looking for Brisker Rav on that, and I see the second page, and the Rehab Solomon's a matzah, but yeah, the first page, what? You have the, what? But I have there's another page of Mr. Rob. They did that copy of the page. Okay, I thought you made a copy of that page. You got the wrong page here. What?
On the back.
On the back of that page? Back of that page is Mr. Rob. On the next page? No, that's Alice Yaka. Let me put the page. Okay, so I'm sorry I didn't make the copy of Mr. Rob. I have a copy. How much we saw the first page? I'm going to give you the second page. I'm sorry. That's what David Mr. Rob asked. Mr. Rob asked that this Rambam. But the Rambam says, Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. This lotion, the quote that I have, I'm sorry to give you that page. But Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim, Shesho Alecho B'Yom Kippur, they have a lotion of Rambam. So he says, for the lotion is Masha from the Rambam, it's a Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. So in other words, we know he's a Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. Not that he's determining that he is a Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. It's a Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. We know already. Let's say he's already been diagnosed. Seems like we know he's a Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. Sometimes the Gemara says the guy was stabbed, and something like that, you know, that makes Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim, or let's say it's Machla, that the doctors have said, so it seems like Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. The mission didn't say Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. The mission we saw in Yuma just said a Chola, that the Chola, yes, the doctor, what did you do? And then it says you can the doctor to know the book, so you can ask him. But the Rambam discusses this halacha, he says Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim, Shesho Alecho B'Yom Kippurim. So Brisker Rav says, so why does the Rambam say Davka Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim? This Mashma Halacha, according to the Rambam, is only discussing a case where we know the person is already Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. And then he asks the doctor, you know, should he eat, should he eat? He asks the Chola, should he eat, should he eat? But what about, what? I mean, the Chola really, he knows what's going on with him. It says, Leila Dea Mars Nasho. So why did you say, he can say, I'm Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. Why can't he say that? Seems like we trust him. I mean, even the doctor doesn't know. We trust him more than the doctor. So the doctor says, you don't need anything. He does it. So you see that we do trust him. So why can't we trust him also the same Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim? I know I'm going to die. The guy comes to you and he says, I'm dying. So that person is dying. I've heard that from people. I'm dying. You know, so let's trust him. Well, you know, it seems like you know. The Rambam says Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim, says the Brisker Rav, it's Mashma. This halacha, according to the Rambam, even though the Mishnah didn't say that. Mishnah says Chola. And the Chola, you can go to the doctor and find out you're sick. But the Rambam says the Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim, the only person we know for sure is sick or is determined, let's say he was stabbed, let's say one guy got killed yesterday in Israel. This guy Fogel was killed yesterday, an Arab stabbed him, so then okay, was killed, a terrible thing. So terrorists killed him. But so that's Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. So, or a person with cancer, so we know it. But the Rambam says that awful in that case, the mission says stop, hold up. So why can't he determine? Now, actually, look at this. We have the Brisker Rav. Brisker Rav brings also for Ramban. The Ramban says Mufurish. The Ramban says in the Sefer of the Ramban, the Ramban says Mufurish that the Chola can tell you that it's Sakana. He says Mufurish, and Beis Yosef brings this Ramban, that a Chola a person can tell you it's a Sakana. He can tell, just like the Gemara says that the Chola can tell you more than the doctor if he's going to live or die, exactly. So the Chola can also tell you that Sakana. Because he feels he's going to die, he feels very sick. You know, as Mr. Rav says, it seems like from the Rambam that it has to be determined the reason why he can't tell you that. So why not? That's what he's trying to figure out. Why can't he? He can tell you, no, I got to eat, I need it to live. So why can't he tell you I'm a Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim? That's the first question we have. That why the Rambam doctor mentions a local Chol Sheish Mo Sakonim. And the Rambam says before, and the Beis Yosef brings the Rambam, that a person can also tell you that though I wasn't diagnosed, they could say, I feel that I, according to what he says, you're allowed to feed them. That's the real God. So he wants to know, does the Rambam argue with that? Seems like he does. And secondly, he says in the Mishnah says we, you know, we go with the doctor's opinion. We go with the doctor's opinion, and then it seems like for the, just like you go with the doctor, you know, the doctor, there's no doctor, so you ask him. So it seems like he's the same weight as the doctor. It seems like, you know, you can ask a doctor, and he has the same weight as the doctor. In fact, I was about a little bit more. It seems like he has more weight than the doctor, the Shaila. Because it says, the doctor says, you don't have to eat. He says, no, I do have to eat. You listen to him. So it seems like he has more weight than the doctor. So if that's true, so why does he have more weight than the doctor also, in general, to tell you how holy is for God? Just like, you see, in Allah, he has more weight than the doctor. If a diet is even the Rambam passing 100 doctors say you don't have to eat. He says, no, I do have to eat. You pass for him. The person on self knows the best way to feel, because if turning something's wrong, he knows, oh, I gotta eat it. Okay? I'm asking. So why can't he tell you also the Holy Spirit? Well, that's the problem. But the scrub says, you see, the halacha, the Mishnah seems to at least equate it to a rofe. And so if the rofe can tell you, suppose it's going to, so why can't he? So number one is why in logic can't he tell you that? Why in logic can't he tell you how the Holy Spirit put it? Why do we have to know he's the Holy Spirit? And secondly, it should be at least as strong, maybe stronger than and the Ramban says explicitly, as brought by the Beis Yosef, that a Kola can tell you, I am Kol Yisrael Kohen, even though I was never diagnosed. I know I got to eat. Okay, you trust him in this all you trust him. Okay, so we have to know, why is it mentioned by the Ramban this way? And why is it, you know, it seems to be strange halacha that we need to have determined that beforehand is a Kol Yisrael Kohen, and why is he less than a doctor? And okay, that seems to be the problem. That now, again, we have over here see the second page over there. We do have in the Hagos Maimoni. The Hagos Maimoni is that you have in the second page over there. The second page in printout is Hagos Maimoni on the Rambam. So over there, you see in that you have one of the pages that Hagos Maimoni, one of those pages. What? You saw it, but people have printed up with the Hagos Maimoni in the second page. Oh, it's here. So there he brings that, he says, brings a Yesh Goinim, Shaposku, Tahin the Dafkik, Shomar, Estakin, Ilo Och. That what he's allowed to eat is only when the Chodah says that, I know I'll be a Sakon if I don't eat. Abel, Imomar, Lo Estakin, Bekach, Ilo Ochel, Oso Machiloi. The guy says, look, I like to eat something. I said, well, you'll get real sick if you don't eat. So those memories from some guy, and he says, well, the guy says, no, I don't get sick. I just, you know, it'd be hard for me to do, you know, I won't be able to do kneeling so good. You know, I won't be able to, you know, raise it on the chazan. I'm not going to kneel. I got to eat a little snack. No, you can't eat that. You got to be enough. Right? And he says, you know, if I rest now, I'll be able to be okay. Some people, you know, they want to go off, you keep it on resting. You know, they can't. You know, so I says, I want it. So, you know what, don't eat. The guy says, not a sakoni, even though you might be hungry, but he says, that's the lach b'necholda. He says, only if he says, I really feel a sakoni, then you can feed him. Chen Pirish, he brings over there, that Shem Chen Pirish read, Rabbi Shmuel, Avor Benetam, Nechlak al Zeh. Mehor ha'alocha l'maisa l'hetir. He says, no, they can't determine by the cholda says it's going to be a sakoni. V'chi cholim neviyim hei, o'e avukiyim hei. Are they cholim such a brilliant people? Are they in the wood? They know what's going to be. They be a sakana, not be a sakana. Or they're bulky. They know what they know something about medical. They didn't go to medical school. Elakemet shiodeya hacholim or achayim shiru shabbos or yom kippur v'omer anik sorech v'ni yochol lisbol machum sacholim machin lo sorech. He says he doesn't really have to know what he's going to be sakana, not be a sakana. The guy says that I feel like I eat. That's enough. That's what the Jewish man says. No, but the guy says, I feel like I gotta eat, and then there'll be a sakana. Yeah, all right, so we'll talk about that, China. We'll talk about that. It was a good China. So the first sheet that says that Dafke, if he says he feels sakana, the other one says, no, just if he's hungry, it's enough. No, as long as he feels that I want to eat something, even though I don't feel sakana, I just want to eat. And then, I'm weak, and I'm a full of shoes with sakana. If you're weak, it's enough to feed him a bit. What?
Does that mean
he's going to
drop dead right now?
No, but I feel if I don't eat, I can die. Not mean that not now, but it could cause me to die.
What if he has a high illness, he has to go for a treatment,
that project. He would get to what you're asking in a minute. You were talking about that. So, okay, so, but here goes Mami discusses the difference with the Chola has to say. Is enough that the Chola says, I want to eat, I feel I'm really sick, I want to eat something. Or does he have to say, well, if I don't eat, I'm afraid I'm going to die. I'm going to die maybe, you know, right away or not right away, anyway. So let's see also there's a Rambam, a very important Rambam to know on the third page. The Rambam Hilchos Shabbos. In Hilchos Shabbos, the Rambam, it's a very interesting Pesach Halacha in the Rambam. I heard a shir about this recently from Herschel Schechter's son said a shir from his father. Interesting Shaila Halacha, very interesting Shaila. And this Shaila, he quoted the Magen Mishnah, he said, oh, Shaila, you know, somebody, I think he told Herschel Schechter's son, I don't know who he is, but he said that his wife was having problems and he told her that she should go. When she was expecting a baby, she should go before Shabbos near a hospital. So she shouldn't have to call Shabbos. He said a certain cheat, she should go before, it was like the ninth month, she should stay in the hospital before Shabbos, she have to travel. Interesting, Shiloh, you have to do that. I never heard of such a thing, you have to do such a thing. So Herschel Schechter was telling his son that the best thing to do, and then I don't know, I forget the whole plot. She actually had the baby then on Shabbos, but I think she did. But anyway, so, he said over there, the Rambam says in Shabbos, in the third page, Perek Beis Hilchos Aleph, says, Tehuyeh Shabbos Eitz Tekos Amoshes, Kishar Kol HaMitzvahs. So the din of Shabbos, just like we say, Kippur is Doich HaChodesh HaSulachon is Doich HaKoras HaKippur, and also is Doich HaShabbos. A person allowed to, you know, take, go to the hospital on Shabbos, like all the mitzvahs, except for the Gemara Beis. The Fika Cholesh Yesh Bo Sakona, also called Kol Tzmacha B'Shabbos. This is all Sharaba. Also called Kol Tzmacha B'Shabbos. You can do all of his needs on Shabbos. Kol Tzmacha B'Shabbos, all of his needs, is an interesting question. The Shabbos, Afa Pisha Rofe, a woman, also Mokom, a Sovik, should serve the Kalal of Shabbos. No, the doctor's not sure. No, maybe it'll be okay, you know. Yeah. But he says, no, I need it. The Sovik, she don't serve. The Chayne, Mama, Rofe, Chalom Shabbos, the doctor said, you should go. And the guy says, I don't know. But still, then he says, you still go. So the question, so Rambam brings this halacha in the Shabbos, but the Rambam says, it's also called Shabbos. You have to do all of his needs, very interesting. Now there's a Magen Mishnah on this. The Magen Mishnah over there, this is what I heard this year, the Magen Mishnah. I heard it, I think it was in Switzerland, I heard this year, one of these shir that the son of Rabbi Herschel Schechter said, this year, quoted this Magen Mishnah. See the Magen Mishnah, page 3, and it goes on to page 4. The Magen Mishnah explains the Rambam. He says over there, goes on to page 4, I believe. So he says, on the top of page 4, I think, he says, Yeshua Sakona, Mashma, the Lechol Tzrochov, Mechal Ha'avish, Ein, Bemnias Dover, Shosimo Sakona. So he says, Lechol Tzrochov, even though it's no Sakona, he says, if you take this thing, it won't have it. But he wants it. Bemnias Dover, Shosim Sakona. So he wants it. So that you can do it for him. And that for the Choyla Shem Sakona, you'll take away this thing, he won't die. But still, suppose the Rambam wants it, but suppose the Magen Mishnah. The Magen Mishnah, one of the greatest portion of the Rambam, says that Rambam says that you can do Kol Tzrochov means, even though a guy won't die, it sounds like we had in the Shiva Yisrael before, in the Talmud, the guy says that even though, I'm not so good from this. So it seems like this guy, you know, is in the hospital, he's very sick, and the guy says, I gotta watch the ball game. Gotta watch the ball game, you know. And there's no Goyisha, nurse over there. You gotta watch the ball game. So the Jewish friend is watching over there. You wanna watch the ball game? Well, yeah, I gotta see the game. I wanna see what the Cubs are doing, you know. I wanna see the ball game. So, would he die if you don't see the Cubs game? I used to be the guy, you see the Cubs game. But now, the Shaman said that the guy's gonna die, you know, without the Cubs game. Well, according to the Rambam, he says, those are Colts running. The guy wants to see the game. So it seems like they gotta take care of it. You gotta turn on the TV for him. Okay, or internet or something, I don't know. Anyway, so you have to figure out, that's what it sounds like, that you gotta call Tzrof. So let me hear the sheet that mentioned by Goshmaimri and Magen Mishnah and the Rambam, that you have to do that. Now, also on the next page, I think, that same page is the Radvaz. Shas and Juvas, Radvaz. You see that Radvaz over there, it's all Shas and Juvas. So here he says, Shaila, in winter lasais, l'chola sheish b'sakon b'shabas, korav sheim b'am tzorav b'kompah. So, he's talking about not such a big tzorav. In other words, the guy won't die. If, you know, he won't die if you do it. But the question is, can you do it? Eim b'am tzorav b'kompah. So, you know, let's say it's 70 degrees, the guy wants it to be 68, you know what I mean? So, I asked him for that, can you do that? So he said, that's a Shabbos, you can do that for him on Shabbos. So he says over there in the Rambaz, Tshuva, the Rizamach Lake is Benapaisku. So we, like we saw before also, that was what we saw before, and the Machlokes that was quoted by the Ghost Maimon, what a person has to, you know, really has to be a Torah. But Ani Minamekilim. And he says, I'm not making on this. But he can't read it. That the Chuyah here, it's a Shabbos, it's a Sakhoz of Hashem. So it's not Chuyah, the Shabbos is not Chuyah for Sakhoz of Hashem. If you can, you have Mutter Lassos, I feel the Varm Shein Ram Torah. You can do anything, you can have Torah. The guy wants to watch, I don't like that game, I want to see, I'd rather see Boston Red Sox, I love the Ghost. Let's see Red Sox, okay, there's another Red Sox, okay. He says, maybe, no, that, but Lassos, no, I'd get a cat, no. Just Stamazah, you know, Stamazah, you want to see the ball game. No, that you can't do. He says, no, get it. Unless so, but I ain't can't sad sakon of the bushes. I'm on the dwarf sheesh man with ksas tzorah. In other words, let's understand what he's saying over here. He says, if it's no tzorah altogether, the guy's not wants it, you know, he wants it, you know, whatever, you know, could you warm me up? You know, I like a good juicy steak right now. They have the kosher meals in the hospital. The guy says, no, I don't like these hospital meals. I want a good steak. You go over to, you know, go over to McDonald's and get me, McDonald's is not a good place. I guess, I don't know, a fancy restaurant downtown, I don't know the restaurants that much. Must be something real good downtown. Give me a good steak downtown, you know what I mean? You know, I'm a lot of sick anyway, I might as well enjoy it. And give her a guy, wants to, anyway, so he says, we have the Ksat Soref, Rav Shashim, Lotasaloi, Admorim, Sheshim, Ksat Soref, Yobel, Admorim, Sheshim, Soref, Harbe, Vadog Yadua, if you saw the Poshas, Dog the Shabbos. In other words, I understood from Rav Paz, it's interesting, Soref. He's saying that we do the things with a little bit of Soref, because if we don't do that, we may not do the big things also, because we start making Cheshbonos. Well, okay, do this again. We start making Cheshbonos, also it says in Halacha, I think, shouldn't like let a goy do the sakonas and poshas for you, because let a goy, and people think, well, maybe you really shouldn't do this, and a guy may never stop to do it. That's also mentioned in Halacha that says over there, one of the, as the Rishayim say this, Sora, that let's say you want to, a guy has to eat on kippah, let's say, has to eat, or a Shabbos has to eat, and a sick guy. So the question is, can you chef for him on Shabbos? Can you chef the keeper? Can you chef the chef? Can you chef for a guy? No, but we have over here in the hospital tray, the bailiff. Not the bailiff, the kitchen. We got the kitchen has, you know, whatever, not kosher food. I mean, I can chef for him, my son's not a chef. So, hey, he's drunk, you go chef for this guy now. So, the law is you can chef for him. You can put him in chef. You got the bailiff, he's the bailiff, he's a chef. Chef is the Isser Malacha. It's what it allowed this Malacha. Yeah, it says, I'll allow you to chef for a guy. You know? So, why allow the chef? Okay. So, some of the show you explained, because the guy, you're giving a veil, that's an avela, the guy gets sicker. I never in my life get the veil, I'm not even a veil. You know, so that's going to get the guy sicker, because psychologically the guy's going to feel, I can't eat a veil, he won't eat anything. So therefore you allow the chef farm. So a lot of things, I think also the Rambaz is saying that if you won't do the light things, you know, it's not going to be cheshbonos. That's what I think the whole business is going on over here. It's not going to be cheshbonos. And that's the problem. You stop making cheshbonos, so then it can really cause you to come through a real sakonas nefashos. That's what it seems like. It seems like also that the other shita also, we're going to talk about that a little bit more, about what the problem is, you know, when we say we're not doing, even though it's not a real sakonas, or what the chola is saying, okay, so that's what I saw in the Red Vaz. Now, in the Reb Chaim Brisker, as we said, Reb Chaim Brisker, who normally did paskin, this he did paskin about a sick person, a keeper. He said that they should eat regular, and Shulchan Aruch, it says that you give him the muberes, the pregnant woman, here I have it also, the muberes, that she eats pachas with a shear. And so Reb Chaim says that, it says in Shulchan Aruch, muberes and a chola, he says, that's, you look at the Shulchan Aruch, says that Reb Chaim, that chola we're discussing is a chola who could come to this, I kind of like a muberes. A muberes is not what she's going to come. But if she doesn't eat and she gets real hungry, she couldn't get through to become a sakana. That's what he says. That's what it's Shulchan Aruch and it's Gemara. It's a Gemara. Increases not yet gimel. And the Gemara increases not yet gimel. That's the only place it says in Shabbos that you feed a person ma'at when he, like in a kippur on Shabbos, you feed a ma'at, a kippur. It says that Gemara increases not yet gimel. You feed a muberes ma'at. It doesn't say any other called she's sakana. It only says that muberes. So, and then halacha that the Rav Chaim is mechadesh that a real Chosh Makana, then you can feed on normal. You can feed on normally, doesn't have to make a cheshbon, you know, eating a little bit. You can feed on normally. So that's a Reb Chaim says, and he says that. The interesting thing is that the Brisker Rav, the other thing we do have a sheet on that Brisker Rav, the second sheet is the Brisker Rav. The Brisker Rav brings a chinuch. I think we did print out that second sheet, we got the right sheet on that one. That sheet, you have the second sheet of Brisker Rav, where it says Chomtza Matzah. On top of that Chomtza Matzah page, over there he quotes a chinuch. I believe we have that on that page. Yeah, we did get out of it. Somewhere in the chinuch, you see what it says over there? If we're down it, it says, okay, was a chinuch. Where is it said we get over there? Mitzvah Shidiyah, Shidiyah Gimel. I see, I said Mitzvah Shidiyah Gimel, that's the Chinuch. And Kain Masefer HaChinuch, you see that? That's in the middle of the second page over there of the Brisker Rav. Okay, Mitzvah Shidiyah Gimel. She'afir Shekosov Din HaShiurin. So there, the Chinuch, he explains all the mitzvahs in Shidiyah Gimel. He explains the mitzvah that you gotta eat, you know, on Yom Kippur, if you eat, more than Koseves Agasa, so then you're Chayiv Kores, or if you drink more than a cheekful, Chayiv Kores. If he mentions all the Shirin, Lenya Fiyuv and Yom Kippurim, when he talks about the Fiyuv of Yom Kippur, Kosov is El Shoyna, the Fikov, he says, it's quoting the Chinuch, Fikov, Mishu Chola, Av Mishu Embo Sakana, Gemura, Im Yecholo Sharbe, Ruya La Chilo, La Shkoiso, Ma'at, Ma'at, Kishir Shomru. So here that's the Chinuch, very important Chinuch that's spoken here by the Brisker Rav, and he's saying this is a mocker to the court of his father, of Reb Chaim Brisker. Because the Chinuch, when he talks about all the Shiurim, that you know, if you eat, Xeles, Haikores, and drink Malalu, Haikores, and then he says, therefore, a person who is a Chola, She'ein Bo Sakana, explicitly says the Chinuch. In such a case, she says, then you give him ma'at ma'at, that person. You give him ma'at ma'at to eat, and he's allowed to eat a little bit. So why do you miss that Choshen Mosakana? So says the Brisker Rav, or his father understands the Chinuch. Because the Choshen Yesh Mosakana, that's what he's saying, Choshen Yesh Mosakana, you don't have to make this cheshbon. You don't have to make this ma'at ma'at. You can eat regular, because it's mechazik the goof. A person with a Choshen Mosakana has a special halacha. That's what he says, the Rambam also, but that's what Mr. Rav says, the Rambam also, which writes this Allah Chodesh Vakona, he says that, you know, you ask the doctor, and then you ask him, and you trust him. So I understood what Mr. Rav is saying, is that we trust him, in whether he has to eat or not, only as a Chodesh Vakona. In other words, like we saw in the Yagos Maimony, a guy's going to say, he's never been diagnosed with any sickness. So all Chodesh Vakona, you're sick in the head, when you're supposed to be. I know, I feel it, you know. A lot of times a guy has a test, you know. You have a test today, you feel like, I can't come to school, you know? Well, that's not unusual. I can't get to school. He's a bunch of people. So that's not a usual excuse. You know? But anyway, so the Brisker Rav says that this, but the Rambam writes, there's a halacha that on that case you can rely on this guy's opinion. Like, it's only that goes finally that the people, that some guys are not nebuah, and they're not, they never went to medical school. Most people didn't go to medical school, you know. Guy in medical school maybe knows, but he doesn't know. But a guy who didn't go to medical school probably doesn't know. So the thing is, like, that's what the Rambam is saying, which Rambam explains, that this halacha, the Rambam understood, that the halacha, just like the halacha we see, is only mentioned by a Uberis, who's not a Chodesh Makana, then you give him ah. But why is it mentioned by a regular Chodesh Makana? The answer is, he says, because on that person, you don't have to make this cheshbon. Just like we saw in that goes finally, right? We saw in the Lagi Mishnah, also called Tzorocha. Now, what do we call also called Tzorocha? I also understand what we call Tzorocha. I mean, the Rabbana said there has to be some Tzorocha. You know, the guy says, I don't like to see the Cubs, I want to see Boston Red Sox. I don't know if that's a Tzorocha. Well, I'm not sure. We have to measure that. I'm not sure if there's a Tzorocha. Maybe the Tzorocha could possibly that child like possibly. But I say, that, I don't know. But I'm saying there has to be some Tzorocha. Some Tzorocha, right? So then I'm saying that's the Mishnah Rav got this halacha. So the Mishnah Rav said, Rabbi Hirsch was sitting next to me on Shabbos. So he was sitting next to me in Shul because he darshaned over there. Shabbos Shul, he sat next to me. So I was telling him to speak about the Reb Chaim. Well, nobody passed the Reb Chaim. Nobody passed the Reb Chaim. He said, you know, I said, who don't pass the Reb Chaim? He said, well, Mishnah Berurah don't look at the Reb Chaim. They all hold together, ma'at. He said, okay, so Reb Chaim held like that, like that. I'm just saying, I saw that Mr. Zalman Meltzer. He said, Mr. Zalman Meltzer held like the Reb Chaim. So Zalman Meltzer, did pass the Eretz Yisrael. It's not like the Rosh Hashanah is also the Eretz Yisrael. I mean, so the question was, because Rav Frank says, how can we make them? It's such a Chomer D'Kisser. You know, Kippur is a Chomer D'Kisser, how can we make them? And give a guy, you know, to eat regularly a Kippur. So Rav Frank says, yeah, but we're, well, I'm not going to make them a Kippur, I'll be mocking on the world of bushes. That was Rav Frank's language. I hold the mouth from the bush. Who says you mean I'm making a kippur? I'm not from the bush. So you see, though, there is a very interesting Rav Chaim. So the Brisker Rav says that he understands this Rambam. When Rambam says, "Fully just talk about it," that's when he asks the guy what his opinion is. The Rambam says you can ask the guy opinion if you're sick. You know that every guy who has a test says the Fully just talk about it. That's a standard student, any high schooler, but they always say the Fully just talk about it. So that's not there's no riot there. But the guy who's already a Fully just talk about it, then you can ask him. And I understood also. So now,
why?
Because the first one who's gonna, we're afraid that maybe Taka something's gonna happen to him. We're afraid we don't know. Anything is very delicate. His situation is very delicate. If a person like Rotsky said, that guy saw on shoulders as far as no gun, he can't play games. They have to even ask him. Now, but in Aloha, I saw that it's mentioned on the last page. That page, I think, a different one. The Adash Yaakov from my Rebbe Novominsker. And then the Novominsker, well, Adash Yaakov, what?
Yeah. That was funny.
Yeah, say a lot.
Yeah, there was a meeting with clients in the Fashion, and he had a sanitarium for people who suffered from tuberculosis. He used to cure people who had tuberculosis. He did everything.
Said you go to the doctor, and then there's no doctor, you go ask him. So why does it say, just ask him first? This is where the buck, you know, like Harry Truman said, the buck stops here. Ask the fool first. The answer is because most fool will rely on the doctor. You know, most guys, I don't know, I'm going to go to the doctor. So that's what Mishnah says also. Most people don't know the answer. The first thing you go to the doctor, the whole of you, she goes also to the doctor. I also, first you ask the doctor. You don't ask a doctor, you know, you know more than a doctor, you don't know more. So you usually ask, but there's no doctor, or you don't trust, or whatever. So now you're not to go. That's the season of Mishnah. Anyway, as Yaakov says in the last page over there, he wants to say a different shot in the Rambam. When the Rambam Dafki said that he talked about Chol Shisus Hakone, that he said Chol Shisus Hakone, that you asked the Chola, you asked the doctor, why he wants to say a different shot? He brings it to Reb Chaim also. The Reb Chaim was, you know, said that Chol Shisus Hakone, that you don't have to have any questions, you know, that you know, you can feed him a regular, you don't have to give him like pokes on Mashir. So then he says he brings the Brisker Rav there. The Brisker Rav says, because when you feed them regular, it's good for a person to eat. It's always good for a person to eat. Normal eating is healthy. So that's good for the person. In other words, don't keep focused on Mashir. Going to Mashir is not the normal way to eat. It's very, very not geschmack. The person eats the bone of Mashir is not healthy, not normal. People, you sit that way, they eat normal. So then he says, it's healthy to eat normal. Regular, not called what we share. So that's the Brisa Guf. That's how the Brisa Guf understands. So then we have to start making Chajiro, you know, candy, you know, eat, that's it. First of all, just about it. So that's how we understand. That's how the Brisa Guf understood what his father said, it's better to talk about it for the person. Now, in the next paragraph, though, he brings over there, in the paragraph underneath the Sefer, Avi Ezri. Avi Ezri was Rav Shach. Rav Shach was actually very, very close to Mr. Rav. Very close. Shach said of Mr. Rav that I don't know if he says I'm Zohar to go to Mabo, I don't know if I can get better Torah than Mabo than I heard from Mr. Rav. He says, I don't think it can be more Yishmak in Mabo than the Torah I heard from Mr. Rav. Anyway, so he always went to Mr. Rav. He said, but Mr. Rav said, that's the Torah's Emes. So here, though, he says, Mr. Rav said he disagrees with his point. He's interested, he always agree with this car. So he thinks that that's pushy. If it's gonna be better for you, then you should for sure eat. That's not the they don't tell me that. He says, even if it's not gonna be better, that's what he says. Even if it's not gonna be better for you, you can also eat. In other words, like what we said before, you know, the guy wants it, that's enough. That's what the Yashu learned shot. Go wash and sorry. So Perla, this Mitzvah wants to say to the Rambam, that the Rambam is a Chadesh, that even a Chodesh Yisus HaKona, we ask a doctor. That's why he said Chodesh HaKona. Because that guy really, he can eat everything, like, you know, he can eat everything, like the Chaim said. So this is an area why you need to ask a doctor for. What do you need to ask a doctor? You can eat everything anyway. It's Chodesh HaKona. So you have to ask a doctor. That's just, the Rambam is saying the law of Chodesh HaKona, because he wants to teach you that even a Chodesh HaKona, which Rav Chaim said, could eat normal, even that guy is best to find out what the doctor says first. Because the doctor says you don't really have to eat, so don't eat. So the guy says, even that, that's the Kiddush. That's how he wants to live. There's two little matters. So in other words, he wants to say you agree with Rabbah. Then a Chola can also say, I'm a Chodesh HaKona. And he agrees, Rabbah only wrote Chodesh HaKona because he wants to say that even him should ask a doctor, even though Rav Chaim said, you know, you can eat the regular, but still best to ask the doctor first. So, but I don't think the Rambam meant that. I think that I disagree with my Rebbe because I think the Rambam meant that he should have said Chol Hashem Shabbat Oshol Shemar Sakana. You go to the doctor. The Rambam Dafka mentioned Chol Hashem Shabbat Sakana. He asked the doctor what the situation is. The Rambam it should be more clear. You don't have to say Chol Hashem Shabbat Sakana. You ask the doctor. Every guy Chol Hashem Shabbat Oshol Shemar Sakana. Find out what a guy needs to not ask the Chol. So that's what I think. I think the Brisker Rav's shot is more clear.